Hey there, beautiful people. I hope you are having a creative day. In this video, I will teach you a very simple method to create horizontal scroll animation in Wix Studio. So without further delay, let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is change the section colors and add two more sections so that we can visualize the effect properly. I'm going to set this one and then add a section. In this one, we will create the effect. And then one more section so that we can visualize the scroll animation. Let's give it another color. All right. Now we will create the animation here. The first thing we need to do is change the height. So press Alt-I, which will open the advanced size options, and set the height to 300 VH. The VH stands for viewport height. The next thing we have to do is change this into CSS grid. The reason I will tell you later in the video. So apply the advanced CSS grid and change it to 1x3. You can do this in two ways. You can either choose this from here or you can add the rows manually. So I will do this. All right, and it will add three rows. The next thing we're going to do is change the dimension to viewport height. Because we have set the section height to 300 VH, it will automatically divide into 100 VH each. All right. Now, we are going to use the first section of the grid for our animation element. Now, you can use any element you like. Just stack them together and you can use that for horizontal scroll animation. So I can go like this, hold shift, and select all the elements like this and stack them together. Now you can apply the horizontal scroll animation on this entire stacked element. The next option we can use is, of course, the layout tools. So you can use the CSS grids, flexbox, or the repeaters. For this tutorial, I'm going to go with the flexbox. So add some items in it. Like this. Go to the size options and set it to 200 VW. The VW stands for viewport width. Another thing we're going to do is equalize the items so that the dimensions are equal. All right. So this is what we're going to use for the horizontal scroll animation. Now you can go ahead and design each element one by one. There are two ways to do this. You can either go to the layers here, select the item and drag it on top, and you can then edit it on the viewport. All right, that's the first option. The second option is to go to the page settings and select the overflow content to show. And once you do that, you can go outside the viewport and edit the elements right here. However, make sure that once you are done with the editing, you go back to the settings and change it to height. All right, so these are the two methods. Once you are done with that, it's time to add the trigger of the animation. And the trigger will be added into the second grid. All right, so for the trigger, you can use any element you like. I prefer vertical lines or containers. Personally, I will recommend vertical lines. So for this one, however, we're going to go with the container. So go to the containers and add it right here. Make sure the container is in the second grid. You can go to the grid here and change the location like this. So for this one, we will need the middle grid here. Once you're done with that, stretch the container and set the right margin. Because this is just the trigger, so we don't need it across the entire section. Let's also change its color like this. And we are ready to go with the animation. Now, very important, this is just the trigger of the animation, all right? So you have to select this container or vertical line or whatever you are using as the trigger and go to the scroll here, add. And here, the most important thing, select the flex box or whatever you want to animate. All right. This is just the trigger of the animation. When this container or vertical line or whatever you are using enters the viewport, the animation for the flex box will start because this is the trigger. If you don't choose that, the container itself will trigger. You can see in the bracket, it says self. All right, so make sure you select the flex box. So what's happening is this container is triggering the animation for the flex box. All right, make sure you change that. After that, change the animation path to from its design. Okay, and we are ready to go with the animation. For this one, we will need the move. Go to adjust. For the angle, we will need 270 degrees. For the distance, we will need 100 VW. The reason why we are using 100 and not 200, because the width of the flex box is 200, is because the 100 VW is already in the viewport. What we want to bring to our screen is the element, the flex box items, which are hidden outside the viewport. And that is why we are only using 100. Now, the animation area will be 0 to 100%. And final and the most important thing is to set its position type to sticky. All right. You will see that it completes the horizontal scroll animation. However, there are two problems. One, the animation starts on top, and second, it ends with the overlapping of the next section. So we have to fix that as well. The fix for this is very easy. You have to add an offset for the position type. So let's add 10%. And you also have to add a bottom margin of 10%. You can add anything you want, all right? This is just an example. So as you can see now, it does not, attach to the top of the page. Let's increase the margin to 20%. All right. And we have the perfect scroll animation. You can also replace this container with a vertical line. So let's delete this and go to decorative, vertical lines, and add it right here. Stretch it like this. Go back to your animation. Make sure the line is selected. Go to scroll, add. Again, we don't want the line to be animated. We want the flex box. The trigger is the line. The animated element is the flex box. From its design, move, adjust animation. The angle will be 270 degrees. The distance will be in VW and 100. And the animation area will be 0 to 100%. Right, and you will get the same result. Actually, I prefer the vertical line instead of a container because it will make the loading speed a bit faster. But yeah, this is how you add the scroll animation. Now you can change the direction of the scroll as well. So go to the flex box and change the direction from right to left and set the alignment like this, align to right. Now go to the interaction, scroll, adjust animation, and change the angle to 90 degree. And as you can see, now we have the direction in the opposite way. All right, so this is how you create the horizontal scroll animation. Actually, I got a comment on the video. It was just screen recording with some background music. It wasn't too much of an explanation, so I decided to create this video. So this is very easy method to create horizontal scroll animation in Wix Studio. I hope you learned something. If you have any feedback regarding the videos or anything at all, you can tell me in the comments. It helps me a lot to improve my videos. For example, like 2 days ago, I got the comment from someone that the cursor is not visible. So now I have this mark here. So this is how you create the horizontal scroll animation. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching.